Hello, everybody, and welcome back to a brand new episode of NASCAR Heat for Career Mode. I hope you're all having a great day. Today, we go to Indianapolis in both the Xfinity Series and the Cup Series, but there you see the news finally is out. We are going to Chip Ganassi Racing next season for a one-season deal in the 42 cars. Kyle Larson is stepping away for one season to focus on dirt racing, and he said he plans to come back better than ever. Obviously, he's missed the playoffs in each season that we've done in the Cup Series. He has yet to get a single win, obviously, and today is his last chance to get a win to get into the playoffs this season before he steps away, obviously, after the 10 playoff races this season. But we come through here into the Xfinity Series race. We had subscriber Jaden Thompson in the cars. He was on the inside of the 15 there. BJ McLeod, who's likely going to be the driver that ruins Matt Tiff's hopes of making it into the top 30 and getting into the playoffs here today in Indianapolis now, as we would see Jaden slowly move his way forwards throughout this race as he had climbed up to just behind Justin Haley at this point as he went down into turns four past midway point. Now as it came through on the final lap at this point, running just in front of the 19 of Brandon Jones as he went down this front straightaway. It was a bit of a struggle once again here for us in the Xfinity Series as Jaden Thompson comes through to cross the line there to get P11, so just barely outside the top 10, which isn't too bad, and the winner was Christopher Bell. But we come now to qualifying here for myself in the Cup Series in the regular season finale, and we come through to cross the line with a 51.233, and we go P3 here in Indianapolis. So a very solid qualifying effort for us here in the Brickyard 400. Qualifying attempt, Kyle Busch, though, on pole with Joey Logano joining him on the front row.
NASCAR makes its way to Indianapolis Motor Speedway for the Big Machine Vodka Brickyard 400. It's always great coming back here, and this is the final stop of the regular season. So for those drivers on the outside looking in, kissing the brakes would sure feel good today.
All right, thank you, Rick Allen. We're ready to go green here for the Brickyard 400. Clint Bowyer, his last chance to get into the playoffs as well. There's CBJ McLeod, the guy, like I said, probably going to ruin Matt Tiff's chances of making the playoffs. And then Bubba Wallace crashed during qualifying, so he is starting at the back of the field as we are ready to get going for the regular season finale. A surprise winner could still shake things up big time for Brad Keselowski now, as the green flag is out and the regular season finale is underway. Brad Keselowski right there in P6. He would love to just go and win this race here in Indianapolis and not have to worry about getting kicked out of the playoffs due to a surprise winner. So maybe to look for him to get up there. Clint Bowyer just behind me. If I can help Clint Bowyer win this race, I will 100% do so, as we were trying to do that in Bristol. And then obviously the whole pitch strategy thing went downhill after that. Now as we come out of turns two side by side with the 22 of Joey Logano down this back straightaway now, as he's going to try and clear us. But obviously we can think about side drafting him, but I wasn't going to side draft him on lap one, so I just kind of stayed away from him as he went down into turn three. But we go down into turn three and get through there really good, and we clear the 22 of Joey Logano for second place. So the car just kind of stuck to the track really well in that corner, and I was really confident right off the bat with the car and how it was handling here in Indianapolis as we came through down this front straightaway, already closing in on the back of the leader of Kyle Busch, who recently got win number 74, puts him within two wins of matching Dale Earnhardt's win count here as he tries to do the same thing here today in Indianapolis. But we came through on the back straightaway now in lap two, right on the back of the 18 at this point. Thought about making a move up the inside, but I decided to try and wait for another straightaway, and we came through now down the front straightaway, coming through to lap three. Sure enough, we launched to the inside, trying to make the move on Kyle Busch. Nine laps to go here in stage one. We're going to be side by side into turns one. Busch on the top, and he's going to carry the momentum and actually hang on to the lead here as we exit turns one. So definitely tried to make the move, couldn't quite make it work. We come to lap four, and I decided I want to obviously have another shot at Kyle Busch here. So sure enough, use that draft down this back straightaway, way ahead of third place and on back. Myself and Kyle Busch, definitely the class of the field at the beginning of this first stage, as we're going to be side by side going down into turn three, trying to make the move for the lead with the 18, but he has the momentum again and he stays clear on the exit of turns three. And as that's happening, there's actually trouble behind us. A 9 car of Chase Elliott goes spinning as it looks like it was the 11 of Denny Hamlin blowing an engine. That's going to bring out a caution here early in stage one and set us up for a restart. Hamlin is actually going to be out of the race here in Indianapolis. So we line up in P2 as the green flag is back out just past the halfway point of this first stage here in Indianapolis. Behind us is Joey Logano and Eric Jones on that second row as we go down into turns one. And immediately the back end just kicked out from me. And I got into the side of the 18 of Kyle Busch, and I could tell right off the bat the handling of this car had completely went on me as the car was just starting to slip and slide. There you see through turns two, we're slipping and sliding a little bit again. And the 88 of Alex Bowman hops on the opportunity. He gets side by side as we go down this back straightaway behind the one car of Kurt Busch for Chip Ganassi Racing, who is now going to be our teammate next season as we're going to slice to the inside of the veteran now as we go down into turns three. The one-time champion, Kurt Busch, has actually hit the apron there, and then we're sideways again on the exit of turn three. Kurt Busch hangs on to the position for the moment as we go down into turns four, so immediately noticing a big difference here on this restart as the car was just slipping and sliding through the corners, and I knew right off the bat we were probably in for a really rough last handful of laps of this first stage as Kyle Busch leads away. Now, once again, though, we slice to the inside of Kurt Busch as we go down into turns one here on lap 8 of 11 in the stage, and then I just didn't quite have the handling of the car at this point to be able to do anything, and Kurt Busch would stay clear of me. Then he would make a move to the inside of Logano through turns three. We get sideways there on the exit of the corner. We hang on to it now, but you can just see how much of a struggle it was. Usually when I tap the apron like that, we can hang on easily, and the car will push up a little bit, but now it was just starting to get loose out of turns two. Now on lap 9, it got loose again, and then I hit the wall with the right side of the car, obviously, and we would lose a bunch of ground. The 20, the 2, the 88, Jones, Keselowski, Bowman, they all go by me, and we drop down to P7. At this point, I was just hoping a caution was going to come out, because you can see just how much I was struggling at this point here in the final, or first stage. Now as we're slipping and sliding through turns 3 again as we go down into turns 4 at this point. Now and then the caution actually comes out and completely saves us here from a complete disaster at the end of stage 1, so we got really lucky with that now, as everyone would come to the pit lane for two cans of fuel, four tires. Obviously, I do that, repair the car, make a wedge adjustment, and even a tire pressure adjustment, very slight tire pressure adjustment, hoping that we can tighten up the car for the long run as we get ready to go green. The car changed drastically between the caution and the restart under the last stage. So hopefully here as stage 2 gets underway, we're going to be able to hang on to it a little bit more on that long run. Because obviously we put up the wedge quite a bit. We put down the tire pressure on the right sides a little bit. And hopefully that will equal a better handling car on the long run. We're going to see what it turns out to be here. As it's 12 laps. So we actually, I think, have an extra lap here in the stage 2 versus stage 1. Now as we're going to be side by side with Bowman. And we're going to clear him out of turns 2. But now we're going to go to the inside of Keselowski. I thought about making it 3 wide. You could probably tell I thought about it. But then I decided to just kind of play it safe right here. It's only the first lap of the second stage. It's not really a big point to go sending it up the inside 3 wide into turns 3. Now as we're just behind the 2 of Keselowski there. Bowman's still right behind us. Bowman was so strong earlier in the season. He won at Las Vegas. And it looks like the trend of him getting one win a season is going to continue. As I really thought this would be the season where we would see Bowman go get 2, 3, maybe even 4 wins. Now as we are going to go 3 wide here with Eric Jones and Kurt Busch, there's across the line easily clearing Jones. I didn't really want to push the issue on him, but I was so much faster than him, I just didn't see a point of just waiting anymore. So now we're side by side with the one of Kurt Busch right at his left rear. We came through down the front straightaway on the next lap, still side by side actually with Kurt Busch as we go down into turns 1, as he did not want to give up the position, and neither did I. I really wanted that position now as we go down into turns 2, so I decided into turns 3 we're going to send it in a little deeper than usual. We slide up in front of the 1, but we take the position, and now we're on the back of the 22 of Joey Logano, a chance to make the lunge now and get back into second place as Kyle Busch is driving away from the field. We're going to be side by side with the Penske driver as we go down into turns 3, side by side with Logano, and we easily take the position away from him. Logano certainly could be a threat to get his third championship here this season. Remember, he is a two-time champion after winning the championship in our rookie season in a wild last lap. Now as we slip and slide though at a turn 4, and then Kurt Busch hops on the opportunity. He catches me off guard. He gets to my inside now as we try to side draft him down this front straightaway. He still gets clear, and we drop back down to P3. Not what I wanted to see was Kurt Busch get back out in front after we worked so hard to pass him, and then I overshoot turns 1 a little bit now, and then the 2 of Keselowski is going to get to my inside as well, as all of a sudden we're just fading again as we go down into turns 2. The 88 would go through as well now as we exit the corner, and we actually clip the wall a little bit. The 20 would briefly get past me, but we would actually repass the 20 and still hang on to P5 as we came through on lap 6 now of the stage. And once again, the back end of the car was starting to slip out on me, and surprisingly earlier than the last stage, now as you see behind us though, the 31 of Tyler Reddick has gone crashing through turns 2, and that would bring out the caution. That's not the first crash he's been a part of today, but no one would come to the pit lane, so we would stay out and get right back into the action here from P5, but that was a pretty heavy hit there for the 31 of Tyler Reddick. Now, as I believe he is surprisingly still in this race, maybe he might be out, I'm not sure. There is two dots on the pit lane. We know one of them is Denny Hamlin. Kyle Busch, though, clear of Keselowski and his brother of Kurt as we go down into turns two side by side again with the 88 of Alex Bowman as he's going to get the position as we exit turn two. You saw behind us there, the 20 actually got in the wall on the exit of turn two there. He did that in Darlington right in front of us, too, last episode. Now's the 88. He's weaving and bobbing all over the place, all over the road goes the 88 of Bowman, but we get to the inside of him as we go down into turn three, and then I hit the apron, so we slide up, and now we're sideways again, and we hang on to it now, still side by side with the 88 driver of Alex Bowman. Boyard getting into the mix just behind us now, as I just didn't quite have that pace to get past the 88 now as we came through down into turns one, still side by side with Bowman, doing what I can to get ahead of him, but once again we're sliding on the exit of turns one, a big slide all the way down to the apron there as we get on that white line, and now we're going to slide up into turns two as we head a terrible line going into the corner now as we exit turn two, and we get hit there on the right front by the 19, and we nearly hit the inside wall, and all of a sudden we drop down all the way to P15 behind the 37 of Chris Buescher. An absolute disaster of a half a lap or so as we go down into turn three. Thankfully, we had the speed, though, to still be able to work our way a little bit forward as we came into the final lap now of the second stage, up a few positions to P13. Keselowski had taken the lead. He is still winless this season and knows that if we get a surprise winner today, he will be out, and here he is leading the way on the final lap of the stage as we get past Blaney, and now as we also now pass the 24 of William Byron, who has to win. Both drivers behind us right here have to win to get into the playoffs, and it's pretty clear they're not going to be able to do that today as they do not have very much speed as we exit turn four, still sliding around as we go down this front straightaway, but thankfully we're going to hang on to at least P11 here in the second stage. So both stages so far we didn't really get a finish we deserved, unfortunately, but we at least are still in this race without wrecking the car. And we got Keselowski with the stage win, a playoff point for him. We would obviously pit for two cans of fuel, four tires, and there you see the two drivers out. It is Hamlin and Tyler Reddick, so Tyler Reddick is indeed out of this race after that one crash there earlier in the stage. And once again, I had to put more wedge in the car to make it tighter, but I didn't. I was scared I was going to go way too tight on the car, so I decided to just go 49.7 and then put the right side tire pressures down, and I would assume putting the tire pressures down makes it tighter. I hope so anyways, but we would gain one spot to get up to P10 here for stage three. Eric Almirola on my inside now as the green flag is out, and we are underway here for the third and final stage of the regular season. Brad Keselowski is doing everything he needs to do right now to make sure he will be that last car in the playoffs. It's a big surprise to right now say that Martin Truex Jr., Keselowski are two of the drivers that are in that final three spots to get into the playoffs right now, as you expect Truex to have a win. You expect Keselowski to have a win. Eric Jones is that other driver in on points. There's only three drivers in on points. Eric Jones has had a great season. He is the worst Joe Gibbs Racing driver in the point standings right now, but he's still P6 there as we go slicing through the middle between the JGR duo of Truex and Jones. Now as we also get up the inside of our Stewart Haas Racing teammate of Eric Almirola, we clear him to take over the 8th position, and as we go down into turns 4, I play a little bit safe there with the 14 of Boyer, knowing the situation for him. Obviously, we want to see Clint Boyer win this race, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen. But down this front straightaway, I decided I'm going to give him a huge shot to the bumper. He goes to the outside of the 18 of Kyle Busch. Like I said, I want to try and help Boyer get this victory, but it just doesn't look like it's going to happen. And if he just didn't move up a lane for the last lap in Bristol, he would have been in the playoffs anyway. So a complete error on his part, a stupid mistake on Boyer's part at Bristol, and unfortunately it's going to cost him a chance at making the playoffs, because it's pretty evident that 14 doesn't have very much speed because he's already drifting back. We go to the inside of him as Keselowski leads. Kyle Busch, you can tell, has fallen down the order quite significantly down to P6 as we go down into turns 3, just behind the Joe Gibbs Racing champion here, the one-time champ still. Now as we came through on lap 29 down the front straightaway, we actually slice to the inside of him and his brother Kurt, three wide as we go down this front straightaway. P5 all of a sudden up the inside of the 22 of Logano as well. As we go down into turns one, we slide up a little bit there, so we're going to be three wide on the exit of the corner. Not a lot of room, but we do make it work as we go down into turns two, trying my best to clear that 22. Sure enough, we do clear Logano, but in the process of doing that, we push up, and then we're going to be three wide in the middle. Logano on the bottom, Kurt Busch on the top behind us, is Boyer And Kyle Busch is still three wide in the middle going towards turn three. We're going to side draft to one car just a little bit now. As we go down into the corner, the 22 slides up into the side of us, and now he goes sliding through turn three. We've had a bunch of incidents with the 22 this season, and that's just going to kind of add on to it now as we come through turns four. And recently, Logano voiced his displeasure with us a little bit when we actually insulted him after, I think it was Bristol or Darlington. But either way, we would clear him there as I wasn't about to go and wreck him and then mess over Brad Keselowski or something. Now, knowing the situation of the regular season finale, so we just kind of get past him and get this situation over with now as we would get to the inside of Kyle Busch, but he would clear me, and then sure enough, he would get past his brother of Kurt Busch, who's actually gotten into the back of Kurt on the front straightaway. Now, as he kind of came over to the left there, is that I already gotten there. Now, as we have seven to go, and once again, there's trouble behind us in turns four. The 71 goes spinning through turns four, and he's going to come up right in front of traffic. A big hit there for the 96 of Parker Kligerman. That was definitely heavy contact for him as he went head-on into the safer barrier. That brings out a caution with seven laps to go. We have seven laps to fuel, but no one pits as this would line us up P5 for potentially the final restart of the race and the regular season. Keselowski and Bowman on the front row. Larson up here in P4. He could maybe find his way into the playoffs here with the news coming out that he won't be in NASCAR next season in our career mode as he's stepping away to focus on dirt racing for a season. He would love to get one final win, obviously, before he does that move. Logano side by side with Kurt Busch just behind us as the two Chip Ganassi Racing cars on the top. There's actually made contact with the 42 there on his left front with my right rear, as now Kyle Busch finds his way back up into the second position. We know Kyle Busch has a fast car. I think he was on pole as we go down into turns three side by side with Bowman for that third position. Sure enough, there the 88 though will hang on tight as we exit turn three side by side as we go down into that fourth corner. Kyle Busch putting the pressure on the two car now as we hit the apron and slide up into the 88, and I kind of chop his nose there on the exit of turn four. I definitely could have given him more room, and unfortunately in that little mess right there, that allows the 18 and the 2 to run away, and we wouldn't be able to hold on to that draft very well. As the 18 now on lap 38 would make the pass for the lead, as you can see right again, I'm starting to slip and slide around at this point, just kind of hoping I can make it to the end of this race as we approach two laps to go. Kyle Busch takes the lead with two to go. Keselowski, you know he wants to get a win here before we start the playoffs. We came through now starting the final lap here in Indianapolis, and surprisingly, Kyle Busch did not pull away from Keselowski. Keselowski was putting the pressure back on down into turns one. He was right on the back bumper of that 18 of Kyle Busch as we come through, going a little bit wide on the exit, and then we slide on the exit of the corner. Bowman still just behind us, Logano lurking, as well as Keselowski actually gets to the inside of Kyle Busch as we exit turns two. Still sliding, I am, on the exit of the corner down this back straightaway for the final time. In front of us, it's side by side for the lead. Keselowski looking for his first win, surprisingly, of the season. And into turn three, he's going to take over the lead here in Indianapolis, looking for his second career Brickyard 400. He took one away from Denny Hamlin a few years ago, and he tries to take it from Kyle Busch as the 88 gets on my inside, actually, as we go through turns four. And we're going to be sideways on the exit of the corner. And now we hang on to it, now trying to stay out of pit road. And we're going to fall down to P6, but Keselowski comes through to get win number one on the season in the Brickyard 400 here in Indianapolis. We crossed the line in P6, should have been P3 or 4, as I was slipping and sliding out of turn 3. The 88 got into me, or not into me, got to the inside of me going into turns 4, and then I just got really loose on that second lane, unfortunately. But still, P6 to end the regular season, can't complain. Truex actually DNF'd there, so very unfortunate for him, but I said really fast in the short run after the race. But we kept losing grip as the race went on, or as the run went on, but I'm certainly excited for the playoffs, especially when we get going for Las Vegas. In the next episode is Las Vegas, certainly one of my more favorite mile and a half. It usually produces some of the best racing, I think, of a mile and a half in this video game. So definitely excited for that one. And as always, if you guys enjoyed this episode, make sure to comment, like, and subscribe. But don't go anywhere yet, because you're about to see the playoff grid here. Obviously, Tift did not get in the top 30, so Keselowski, obviously with the win, is in now as we are getting ready to start the playoffs. 16 points to the good, so not very good, as we knew this playoff grid was probably going to be pretty close due to the kind of surprise factor. Jimmy Johnson, Michael McDowell, Ryan Newman, Tyler Reddick are the four drivers currently out. So we're going to see how that shakes up here as we get ready for the first race of the playoffs in the next episode at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. Certainly excited for it, and hopefully you guys are as well, as we have one final chance to get a championship before we go to the 42 car next season. So let's see what we can do this season. Thank you for watching, everybody, and have yourselves a great day.